I bet 95% of you guys don't know the answer to this question. Who are India's youngest self-made billionaires? If you already know this, great, you're already ahead of the game. You understand the Indian business landscape. But for those who don't know, this case study is for you. So, the youngest two billionaires are brothers called the Turakya brothers, Bhavin and Divyang Turakya. And this is their story. So let's go back to the starting. The brothers were born in a very humble household, nothing fancy, not very wealthy. Their dad was a CA. This was in the 80s, okay, when they were born, and late 70s, early 80s. And the one thing that really was amazing about them is that their father encouraged them tremendously to read a lot of books. In one of the interviews, Divyang says that his house would have piles and piles of books in a room which is, you know, tiny enough, but they would have stacks of books. And the good part is that these two brothers, they would just consume knowledge like just so quickly. They would not read one book a week, not read one book a day, but they could read books, plural, per day. That's how they started consuming knowledge, and then they would consume knowledge about commerce, about business, about programming at such a young age, right? So this was the era when computers were really picking up. Already in the world, they were really well used, but they were really coming into India. In their school, they had a computer class. Now, these two teenagers, around 12, 14 year old kinds of at that age, they would go to school, wait after school, use the school's computer lab because they couldn't afford computers, and they would sit in the school computer lab and teach themselves programming. Now, after that, they started teaching other students, and I've heard they even were teaching teachers about programming. So at that age, right, they were already reading books, learning things outside of school and applying them. They had a big, big affinity to video games, but the dad said, you know what, if you like video games so much, why not make games? So these two kids, at such in their teens, they came up with a game, a business game, where the goal was, okay, the player can only win if they capture 100% of the market share in that game. Just think about that, right? You're so young, you're in your teens, and you have the business acumen to say that the way to win is to dominate a market space. That's what they were doing when they were teenagers. Anyways, as they started growing, right, their computer knowledge in this, still in school, right, they became well known to large companies. If any of you have heard of NASCOM, right? Now what happened is NASCOM is a giant company and they had computer issues. Somehow they connected to these two brothers, and these two brothers solved their computer, internet, technology issues. And that's how they started making money, by doing contracts on a freelance basis from school, I mean in this at school age, with giant companies. And that's how they started understanding more and more about the real world. Now, in 1998, right, they started this company called DirectI. DirectI, if you search, it is a massive technology consulting company, which is now obviously global. And they started it with the sole purpose of consulting. And they started doing things which are a little ahead of the curve. By ahead of the curve, I mean, if any of you are into websites, right, you know that to purchase the domain name, the .com, you have to go to places like GoDaddy or Bluehost. These are the kind of places. For example, zelleducation.com, the domain we've purchased from GoDaddy. That way, early on, there was a company called BigRock, where you go on BigRock and you purchase domain names. That was owned by the Turakya brothers. So same thing with web hosting and things like that. So under the DirectI umbrella, they would have so many different ventures. Now, fast forward, in 2014, they sold 4 units of theirs, okay, to a company called Endurance Group for $160 million. That is massive. Even before that, by the way, for you all to understand, DirectI was growing at an unprecedented pace. It was already one of the fastest technology, it was ranked 10th. They went from, in the first year, from $5,000 sales to $10 million in 2 years. for those who don't understand the magnitude of these guys, that does not happen easily, right? It is extremely rare for a company to do that well. And it was all self-funded. They basically never got on an investor. They had 100% of their company. They would make a profit, reinvest that profit, and just grow from there on. That's how these companies grew. That's how these two brothers basically started growing. So they sold four of the units to Endurance for $160 million. Guys, these two brothers, by the time they were 18 years old, they were millionaires. Millionaires at the age of 18 by self-studying, by applying it in the real world, by having the boldness and the ability to talk to giant companies where they had more expertise, take consulting projects, understand how to start a company, and they did it all by themselves. That's how powerful, at least their brains were that powerful for these two brothers. So this was sort of partial journey of DirectEye. Now I'm putting DirectEye on the side, and there's another company they started called Media.net. Now Media.net was again very ahead of its time. But Media.net, a separate company they did, was it specialized in something called contextual advertising. For those who don't understand what it means, it simply means that today, how when we go on, whether it's on any, you take any website and you'll see ads which are related to something we had searched for before and things like that. So that ad is contextual, based on either what we were searching for before or maybe something to do with the website we were on, and it is trying to promote so that we click on that ad and then the company makes money. Now that concept is obviously very clear now to everybody, but back in the day, okay, a few years ago, it wasn't. They are one of the first people to start it, right? And Media.net started doing like DirectEye tremendously well. Now, for you guys who want to know how do they achieve the billionaire status, Media.net. Media.net, they sold to a Chinese company for $900 million in cash, right? Most of the time, these kind of such massive deals happen when, there is a stock swap, which means I'll sell my company and the company which is acquiring me, I'll get part of their stock because they don't have that much cash to give me, right? When you get so much money in cash, you have an incredible deal. And I'll tell you one thing, I used to work in an MNC where MediaNet was our client in a particular department, okay, in transfer pricing it was called. And my seniors had met the Turakya brothers, and they were always in awe of how these young people were so sharp, so brilliant, that these chartered accountants with such immense experience would explain something complicated. Most of the other companies, they would have a whole team of CAs and all, and they would try to understand. There would be a lot of back and forth. For Media.net, my seniors would go talk to the Turakya brothers. In one go, these guys had complete clarity of what was spoken. In fact, they would be able to discuss it with their understanding being so clear that, okay, can we do this to save the company more money, or what about this? That's how clear these guys were. It does not happen that easily, trust me. Coming back to the Chinese company that they sold it to, when they sold it, Bhavin, the older brother, went for the discussion. Now, the Chinese company literally had a table with obviously the main decision makers, the board, they had lawyers, they had their CEOs and everyone. And on this side, Bhavin was sitting solo. He did not need anybody to help him sell his company, no matter how many people who were technically superior to him were sitting ahead of him. That is the brilliance of these guys. And he came out with $900 million in cash. That is what happened to Media. You guys search for MediaNet online and you can just read about the sale. It was incredible. And that took them to the billionaire status. Right? 18, they became millionaires. Probably by 30-ish, a little more than 30, they would have been billionaires. So that's how powerful these guys are. I keep saying powerful, but what I mean by powerful is basically how smart, how incredibly ahead of their time these two kids were. All self-made. Now, today, if you go to our website, okay, there's a chat box right, where you can chat with us live. You can put in details and things like that. So that live chat box today we use is called Talk2, TAWK.TO, Talk2. That is also under direct time, right? So it is just incredible how far these guys reach us without us even knowing. You might have not even heard about them because unlike, obviously the other billionaires have done maybe better work, but we know whether you take the obvious ones, Elon Musk and Bill Gates and Jeff Bezos, or you take the Indians, right? Most of y'all would have known about Rakesh Jhunjhunwala. You all know about Damani. You all know about these people. But the Turakya brothers have an amazing story which all of us should know. By the way, if you were to know what these kind of people can do for hobbies, Divyang's hobby is piloting planes. Like, he'll go to chill by piloting a plane. Right now, I think one of them is staying in San Fran, probably the other one is in London, if I'm not wrong. And you should see their lifestyle. Like at that age, right, they're driving the best cars, having the best house. And all of that said aside, they are still working on companies which are growing more and more. It's not like it was a one-time fluke and they became lucky, they were ahead of the game. These guys know what it takes to make business work. So now they're working on certain other units or companies of theirs. One is called Flock, one is called Ringo, one is called Radix, one is called Zeta. And they feel that these companies would be even bigger than MediaNet or what they sold to Endurance or even Directa as a whole. That, guys, is the story of our Indian youngest billionaires, from literally a rags to riches story with nothing. No capital, no influence, nothing. Just work and be smarter than others. Work extremely well so that you are literally ahead of the curve. Take risks and look what can happen. I hope you all enjoyed this. If you like, please do subscribe. And finally, if there are any case studies which you would like us to research on and explain it in a story format, please do let us know. Thank you.